Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Pastor Patrick. I would like to welcome you to our first Sunday video. By the grace of the living God, hallelujah, through whom all blessings flow, hallelujah. The Lord has made a way. Praise God, all you creatures here below. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters, we've had a kind of a static website, Church of the Firstborn, for the last 2 years, and the active part of it was the prayer team. But by the grace of God, brothers and sisters, God has opened a way for us to have a dynamic, awesome website with news links of current news related to end times, with Sister Linda Kirby doing her What's Going On newsletter on there, and updated live articles and discussion of the latest news events related to the end times and the return of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We have chat rooms, prayer rooms. Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm excited too. I know lots of people be excited about those end times, live feeds we will have of news articles related to the end times and the chat rooms and the prayer rooms. It's going to be exciting, brothers and sisters. We have rooms where people can be prayed for healing. We have an elder in our group, that Brother Terry from Australia, who has a gift of healing. Praise God. And has mighty miracles in his ministry that he's pretty new at. And God is just multiplying the miracles through him. And he will have a prayer room. And others of us can join in. For the Bible says one can put 1,000 to flight. Two can put 10,000 to flight. Brothers and sisters, imagine what 100 people can do. Or 1,000 people can do. Hallelujah. Look what we can do in Christ, who gives us this glory and the strength to do his will. Hallelujah. For we can do all things through Christ, who strengthens us. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. I'm kind of fired up. You know, I never watched my videos. I went back and watched a video I had made that I'd made at a Methodist church called, Message to the Laodicean Church. And I'm going to ask the brother who's designing the website, since he's still working on it because it's still new, we can put that video in there. I'm going to send him the link. But we have a website administrator, a sister Karen. And her email will be on here and stuff. Any suggestions or ideas for correction on the website, she'll be the one to send those to. We'll have her email on the website if it's not on there already. And we'll also looking for people who can also help moderate the chat room. Brothers and sisters that I already know, I asked you if you feel led. Maybe some of you that stay up all night, or some of you that are up early in the morning, can make a few more administrators for the chat room. In case we have any problems, we can always remove anyone that would use foul language or any kind of trying to bring, as God says, one of those sins that God hates is someone that sows discord among the brethren. You know, people talk about the seven deadly sins. That one of those things that God hates, it says God hates, is those who are, spreading discord among the brethren. Hallelujah. So we want peace and unity in Christ, and to be of one mind and one spirit. As the Apostle Paul said, there's one baptism, and there's one body, and there's one Lord above you all and in you all. Hallelujah. The Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So I say this. I don't know if I've said it in the video. I used to say this all the time. I said that, Jesus asked us to follow him. He said, those who are led by the Spirit, these are the sons of God, are the children of God. Romans 8:14. So I say, if I'm following Christ and you are following Christ, then how is it that we're not walking together? For the Word of God says in Amos 3:3, how can two walk together except they be in agreement? Hallelujah. So we have to be in agreement. Because if I'm in agreement with Christ and you say you're in agreement with Christ, well, we should be together, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Let's not be divided. Hallelujah. Now, this is different. There are people that are overly sensitive about, being in unity in the body of Christ. They think division is what makes people Christian, to be separated and divided and all that. But brothers and sisters, there's both sides. It's just like when you look at the, greasy hyper grace versus, legalism, and people trying to be, Judaizers and telling people, they have to, go to, follow the feast and be an Israelite. And those who say, hey, do whatever you want, live like hell and you're going to heaven. Same thing is true in this area too, brothers and sisters. There are those who are ecumenicalism, like what the video that the Pope just made, saying that, we all have the same God. And believe it or not, I had posted this to my Facebook page. Brian Houston, the founder of Hillsong, he says in a video, you can go Google it and look it up, He says in a clip that the Muslims worship the same God as Christianity, which is not true. Because if you go into any mosque, it says from the a surah from the Quran right over the door, it says, you know, God has no son. It's the spirit of Antichrist. It's the opposite. It's not the same God. Because they deny that Jesus is the Messiah. It is of Antichrist. As John tells us in 1 John, you know, who is Antichrist? He denies that Jesus, you know, has come in the flesh. Denies that Jesus is the Son of God. That's Antichrist, of the spirit of Antichrist. So, that's ecumenicalism, when you try to unite all the world's religions. That's totally different. You know, so when people say, you know, let's have unity in the body of Christ, those people who are, you know, hyper-legalists, who hate everybody, condemn everybody, you know, this extreme end of legalism and Phariseeism, you know, self-righteous hypocrites, they don't want anybody to get along, which is of the devil. Then there's those who are like what the Pope is saying, calling for unity of all religions and we all have the same God and all this. That is also of the devil, brothers and sisters. That's why we have to follow. That's why Jesus said it's a narrow way. I mean, think about it. When he says a narrow way, it's just like, it doesn't mean, narrow is the, you know, gate, straight is the gate and narrow is the way. He didn't say, you got to go all the way to the right side, or, oh, you got to go all the way to the left. It's just in the middle, that highway of holiness, Isaiah 35, you go look at that. It's known in, you know, among preachers as the highway of holiness. You know, it's in the middle. Not turning to the right, as Jesus said, in the Bible says many times, do not turn to the right or unto the left. Many times in the Bible. But it's just straight. That straight and narrow way right down the middle, brothers and sisters. It's not hyper grace where it says, oh, you just give mental assent. You say within yourself, you know, in your mind, yeah, I believe the gospel. Then you live like hell. You know, I had hear that from people all the time on the hyper grace or greasy grace side. They'll say that all the time. And then when I say to them, well, what about when Jesus said in Matthew chapter 7, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, went into the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father. You know, so when you take one Bible verse from the Apostle Paul and take it out of context, where Paul says in Romans 10:17, you know, all who call upon the name of the Lord will be saved. You take that out of context. You know, it's an expression, brothers and sisters. Have you ever heard of an expression? An expression is calling upon the name of the Lord. What does that mean? Just saying, hey, Jesus. No. In the context and in the language of the day, he's talking about repenting, calling upon the name of the Lord, to repent, to cry out, to change your ways, change your heart, change your thoughts, and follow Jesus. That is to call upon the name of the Lord. It's not just, hey, Jesus. That's not what it means, brothers and sisters. It's called an expression. It's called an expression, brothers and sisters. Don't let those false prophets and greasy gracers and hyper-gracers rob, kill, steal, and destroy, even as Jesus said the devil does. When people kill, steal, and destroy your salvation or try to block you from the kingdom of God, it's of the devil. Call it out. Because Jesus said the devil comes not but to kill, steal, and destroy, but I have come that you might have life and life abundantly. John chapter 10, he's the good shepherd. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name, brothers and sisters. He's a righteous God and a holy God to be exalted. Hallelujah. And praised and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Praise his name, brothers and sisters. Follow that narrow road, brothers and sisters, the narrow road. So I talked about greasy grace. I talked about ecumenicalism, that we all have the same God and we can unite with Hindus, Buddhists, Muslims, and all that. When Jesus said, now when you say that we all have the same God, just for those who are in that, who believe that, then you are calling Jesus Christ a liar. You're calling him a liar because Jesus himself said, John chapter 14, verse 6, he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. So if all religions lead to God, then Jesus is a liar. So if he is a liar, therefore he is not the Lord. Either he's a liar or he's the Lord. Now, which is it? You know, that's the thing about it, brothers and sisters. I don't know if it's people's limited mental capacity or what it is, or lack of comprehension. But if you have a doctrine, brothers and sisters, you have to think on that doctrine and meditate on that doctrine all the way to the end. What's the end result of that doctrine? Where does it lead to? My Bible says to bring every thought into captivity to the Word of God, every vain imagination into captivity to the Word of God. You know, like in the Bible says, let God be true and every man a liar. Let God be true and every man a liar. So whenever, this is, you know, this is a key way of saying it, breaking it down. Do not read the Bible through the rose-colored goggles of your doctrine, brothers and sisters. But let your doctrine be seen through the clear lens of the Word of God, brothers and sisters. But the Bible says that we're supposed to, that preachers are supposed to rightly divide the Word of God. That's why God gave ministers, elders in His church who teach Ephesians 4:11. For He gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and some teachers for the perfecting of the saints. Now, I mention this all the time. Very few, 99% of the people on YouTube are not called by God to be in the ministry. It's one thing to make a video about the dream you had or a vision you had and share what you think it means and all that. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. But these people, they get some followers, and next thing you know, because of that, you know, as the Bible says, you know, that's why a new Christian shouldn't be, you know, in the ministry, because of pride. The devil will get them through pride. So pride goes before a fall, a haughty spirit before destruction, the Bible says. So they become haughty, high-minded, because they start getting followers, all these people who are running to and fro wanting a date for the rapture. So they get all these subscribers because they think they're going to get some date for the rapture. That's what they want to know. Instead of knowing, am I ready for the rapture? Instead of wanting to know, am I saved? Am I really born again? Am I going to be raptured? Am I going to make it to heaven? They don't ask the right question. They ask the wrong question. When's the rapture going to be? That's the wrong question to ask, brothers and sisters. The secret to wisdom is asking the right questions. And the right question is, am I ready on that day to meet the Lord Jesus Christ? Am I ready right now? Am I bought? Blood bought. Hallelujah. Have I been bought with a price, or am I still my own? For the Bible says you're not your own, but you've been bought with a price, the precious blood of Jesus Christ. So you should ask yourself, oh, hey, that's a whole other sermon. Lord's give me right now. You know, I do my sermon on joy, Jesus first, others second, yourself last. There's a Bible verse right there to go with that. Are you still your own? Are you a bond servant of the Lord Jesus Christ? Are you a slave, a servant, possessed and owned by the Lord Jesus Christ? Are you possessed by the Spirit of God? Hallelujah. That's the question, brothers and sisters. Are you possessed by the Spirit of God? People talk about getting possessed by demons. A demon can only possess someone to a certain point. But the Holy Spirit, when you become part of God, hallelujah, part of the body of Christ, hallelujah, literally and figuratively, that you are, the Holy Spirit clothes Himself in you as He did with Gideon. Hallelujah. Have you been sold out to Christ, brothers and sisters? Let's worship the Lord for a minute. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's worship His name, brothers and sisters. Let's worship Him. Hallelujah. Let's worship Him. Have you been sanctified by the Lord? Hallelujah. 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 Yes, Lord, let your fire fall on us. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let Him sanctify you. Let Him fill you with His Holy Spirit. Let Him fill you with your Holy Spirit, with His Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters. It to the world, no heart, more my heart is turning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. brothers and sisters, let the fire of God get on you. There's a lot of people tell me, they say, Brother Patrick, you know, you preach old school. You preach like they used to preach back in the day. Not that many people alive. You know, when I went to the Methodist church, there was a woman there about 80-something years old. She said, you know, when I was a little kid in this church, we had altar calls. There was people preaching like you. Talk about 1940s, 1930s or something. The woman remembered it. That's how long it's been. But what is it? It's the fire. You know, even John Wesley, the founder of the Methodist Church, he talked about that burning fire in your spirit. Hallelujah. It's the fire of God. Hallelujah. That's what is coming through me. Hallelujah. The Lord has clothed himself in this earthen vessel. Hallelujah. At such a time, he will catch me up, and I'll be gone in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. Hallelujah. And I'll be with the Lord forever. Hallelujah. Not by might nor by power, but by his spirit, by his grace, by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. For whom he has called, he will sanctify, and he'll be sanctified. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He will perfect us. He will glorify us. Hallelujah. By his spirit. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus, who thought it not robbery to consider himself to be equal with God, but made himself in the form of a lowly servant, hallelujah, even to the cross, hallelujah, and suffered and died on the cross for the joy that was set before him, hallelujah. Let that mind be in you, hallelujah. Humble yourself, hallelujah. Jesus said to his disciples when they said to him, James and John, their mother, who's actually Jesus' aunt, sister of his mama, Salome, she said to Jesus, she said, let it be that one of my sons that sit on your right hand and your left. Jesus sat down and talked to his disciples, all of them. They were mad at James and John for their arrogance. And he said, those of you who want to be great in heaven, you'll be the least on earth. You'll be each other's servant. Hallelujah. You want it? That's why the word minister, the word minister really translated into English is servant. To minister to people, to serve them, brothers and sisters. That's what God has called us to do, to love one another, to serve one another, to wash each other's feet. Did you know, brothers and sisters, in those days, can you imagine people walking and there's cow dung and all this in the road, and they're wearing some old Roman sandals, and you walk down a dirt road 20 miles to some town, you go to somebody's house. Imagine what people's feet were like in those days with all the goats and pigs, or whatever. Outside of Israel, they had pigs, goats, whatever, cows, etc. Walking in all that dusty manure and all this stinking mess. And then here's the Lord Jesus Christ, your Lord and your God, is washing some old nasty, dirty people's feet like a slave boy would do. Our Lord Jesus Christ did that. And then you don't even want to pray for people. You know, as an example, in this church, we got about 25 to 30 people now. Say 30 people. Out of the thousands of people that watch my video, 30 people on the prayer team. Just to receive an email and pray for somebody. And here's the Lord Jesus Christ washing people's feet and says that we should do likewise and wash each other's feet. People don't even want to spend 5 minutes serving the body of Christ, serving each other. Talking about they're going to heaven? May the living God have mercy. Thank God for grace. Thank God for grace. Thank God for a new beginning. Because the Lord's mercies are new every morning. Hallelujah. 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 I want to sing that in a minute, but I got to worship the Lord a little bit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise Him. Praise Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let's sing. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. He's faithful who has called us. He is truth and righteousness and faithful. He who has called us, brothers and sisters. If it wasn't for Jesus, if it wasn't for the grace of God and the blood of Jesus, there's a hot hell awaiting all of us, brothers and sisters. We've all sinned and fallen short of his glory. Oh, that we might believe on him who was sent. Hallelujah. That we might believe and rest in the finished work of Christ, brothers and sisters. But know that when we're saved, after you're saved, the Bible says in that same text, Ephesians chapter 2, where it says in verse 8 and 9, where it says, by grace are you saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God, not by works, lest any man should boast. That's for your salvation. Later on in that same text, it says, we're not saved by our works, but we're saved unto do good works. See, brothers and sisters, you have to rightly divide the word. You can't take those verses and just throw everything out. It has to be taken in context. So once you're saved by grace through faith, God has called us unto good works. Be ye doers of the word. As James, the half-brother of Jesus, said, be ye doers of the work. James chapter 1, I believe it's verse 22, not hearers only. Hallelujah, but be ye doers of the word. Again, I go back to Romans 8, verse 14. And 16, those who are led by the Spirit, these are the children of God. His Spirit bears witness with our spirit that we're a child of God. If you're a child of God, you'll be doers of the word. Jesus said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. Now, whenever I say that, I have to go deal with those Judaizers on the other side with trying to say you got to keep the law. That's not what it says, brothers and sisters. Jesus said a new commandment. John chapter 13, John chapter 14, along in there. He says, a new commandment I give unto you. Love one another as I have loved you. For this is how people know that you're my disciples, because you have love one for another. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, get into the steadfast love of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, this is our first video, you know, and I'm just letting the Spirit of God flow and let His victory flow. Hallelujah. Let's just worship Him again, brothers and sisters. Let's take another praise break. Let's worship Him again. I want to do it. I want to worship Him a little bit more. Precious blood. Precious blood. That's it. Hallelujah. Did you repent of your sins? Hallelujah. Praise God. Victory in Jesus, my Savior, forever. He sought me and He bought me. He sought me and He bought me. With His blood. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Believe the cleansing flood of His blood. Hallelujah. 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 He's our Savior forever. Praise God. Brothers and sisters, praise the living God. I want to come on here with you for our first Sunday sermon. Hallelujah. I have a new channel I made. Connected with my account, Church of the Firstborn, and then I'll mirror this. I guess I got to upload it twice onto the other channel, brothers and sisters. Praise God Almighty, through whom all blessings flow. This video will be embedded in the website and many more to follow by the grace of God. Hallelujah. I want to tell you something, brothers and sisters. Jesus is a mighty, mighty warrior on our behalf. Hallelujah. Even as that song was saying, you know, Jesus said, no man comes unto me unless the Father draws them unto me. Hallelujah. So the Lord has sought us and bought us. As I started in the beginning of this preaching that I'm doing, the word that the Lord was giving me in my spirit, which I need to make a video about. You know, are you your own or have you been bought with a price? See, I'm not my own, see. I'm owned by Jesus. Hallelujah. He's my Lord, my Savior, my Master, my King. So I'm a subject. I work for Him, you know. It's not about what I want to do. Hallelujah. For He owns me. Hallelujah. I'm His possession. Hallelujah. And until Jesus is the Lord of your life, people want a Savior, but not a Lord. You probably heard that before. It's a popular way that preachers will say it. Everybody wants a Savior, but they don't want a Lord. It's a whole other message. This is an introduction, this video here, brothers and sisters. So I just want to tell you that God loves you. Hallelujah. Jesus shed His precious blood on Calvary for you and me. Hallelujah. He's given us salvation through faith in His holy name and in the precious blood that He shed for us. For the Bible says, without the shedding of blood, there is no remission or forgiveness of sins. Hallelujah. His blood washes us white as snow, that our soul would be cleansed by His blood in the presence of the Father. Hallelujah. He is our propitiation, the King James says. He is the shield. He is the shield that's between us and the wrath of God. As the Bible tells us, Jesus said in John chapter 3, those who are not born again, the wrath of God abides on them, remains on them. But those who believe in Jesus, the wrath of God has been removed, hallelujah, by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. That's also another sermon. In this message, I'm not really getting into theology that much. I just want to preach it. I want to shout it from the rooftops that Jesus Christ is Lord. I want to bring to bear, hallelujah. That's preaching and teaching, brothers and sisters. You know, a lot of people, they want to hear teaching. You know, I teach. But you got to have preaching. It's the preaching of the word. It's something different, brothers and sisters. For God says in His word, He endures the foolishness of preaching that some might get saved. God considers preaching to Himself as foolishness, but He endures it so that some might be saved. That's how much the Lord loves us. He puts this atomic bomb power in those who are willing vessels, who are called, chosen and few, to stand up against tyrants and dictators and false prophets and tares and weeds and demon people, to stand up and speak truth to power, to speak truth to the powers of this world, powers and principalities, hallelujah, and not compromise, hallelujah, the message of God, hallelujah. That's what God's looking for. That's a whole nother sermon and a call from the Lord, a call from the Lord. He's looking for a few good men, hallelujah. God is looking for a few good men to do His will. Praise God, brothers and sisters, for God is the one who seeks us and saves us and calls us and develops us and trains us and bears fruit through us. Hallelujah. All things we do is by the power of Christ. All spiritual things that we do for God is by His Spirit. Hallelujah. It's not you or me, but Him. Him that gives the increase, as the Bible says. One sows and one waters, but God gives the increase. He's the husbandman, as the King James says, or the farmer, hallelujah, in modern English. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. I want to play, I wanted us to worship the Lord a little bit and give Him the praise, hallelujah. Let's just worship the Lord for a minute, brothers and sisters, as we would call upon His name right now, brothers and sisters. And I just wasn't thinking exactly how I would do it. But I just want to pray for you, brothers and sisters. I want to pray for you, and I want to allow the Spirit of God to move on us, okay? I've been preaching. Now I want us to worship the Lord a little bit. Let's worship Him a little bit, brothers and sisters, for a second. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Good afternoon. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We worship You, Father. We worship You in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord. Father, we just thank You, Lord, for the Holy Spirit, Lord God. Father, we thank You for Your grace. We thank You for Your mercy. We thank You for Your loving kindness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm getting a word from the Lord, which is Belteshazzar, which is the worldly name, the Gentile name that Nebuchadnezzar gave to Daniel, the prophet Daniel. As I just made the video on my channel, those of you who saw it, I made a video called Tribulation in Egypt. And the Lord had given me the name Zaphnath-Paaneah, which is the Gentile name. The world knows Joseph. The Gentile world knew Joseph as Zaphnath-Paaneah, the name. See, I'm getting a prophetic word now. I don't even know what it is yet. But Yes, that's it. You can see it with your own eyes. So Zephaniah and Phinehas was the name that Pharaoh gave to Joseph. Joseph from Genesis. Chapter 41. In the chapter 41 of Genesis, Pharaoh exalted Joseph to his right hand because he interpreted his dreams. He put him in charge over all the kingdom. He put him in a place as Jesus is at the right hand of the Father and gave him a Gentile name, Zephaniah Phinehas, which one meaning of that is he who saves his, who saves the kingdom, he who saves the people. As Jesus, Yeshua means he who saves his people. So King Nebuchadnezzar gave Daniel a name too. It's Belteshazzar was the name that was given, a worldly name that the Gentile king of the whole world, just like Pharaoh was with Joseph, Nebuchadnezzar was to Daniel. And he gave him that worldly name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. Father, we want to praise you right now, Lord. Praise you right now, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, Father. Hallelujah, Father. You are worthy. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy of all praise. We thank you, Lord God, for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for the blood of Jesus. We thank you for the grace, hallelujah, that you've given unto us. Father, we love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Father, I speak your blessing right now. Hallelujah. I speak your blessing over your people, Lord God, right now. I speak the blessings of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob upon your people. Right now, all of you, you know you, and even myself, if they're, and I, you know, there are men of God who I honor. And if they wanted to pray for me and bless me, I would be so excited, you know, to have them pray over me. Any anointed servant of God, I know they're anointed servant of God. I'd be, praise the Lord for them to pray for me. So I'm going to pray for you. And those who respect God's servants, you know, God will bless you. And you receive from them. A lot of people, they think that they can't be, especially on the internet. There's lots of anarchy. But you got to submit to God's servants. He's raised up servants. Ephesians 4:11. I'm going to pray for you right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. There is no one like you. Tell him, there's no one like you, Lord Jesus. You stand alone as God. Hallelujah, that's it right there. Hallelujah, all the earth bows before you. Hallelujah, just like they did Joseph. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Every knee bows. Hallelujah. Make way for the Lord. Make his path straight. Clear the way. Clear the way. Clear the path. For the King is coming. Hallelujah. Hear the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. Who made heaven and earth. Hallelujah. 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 My hand is upon my people. Hallelujah. I set my hand upon my people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You will know them by the fruit they bear. Hallelujah. For if it is by my hands, by my spirit, hallelujah, that all things are formed and made, and without me nothing was made. Hallelujah. I am that I am, the great and mighty living God, creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sanctify thyselves. Sanctify thyselves and prepare to meet the Lord thy God. Hallelujah. 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 Praise you, Lord God. We honor you. We thank you, Lord Jesus, Lord God. Lord, that your hand be upon us, Lord God. Oh, Lord, give us strength. Give us your blessings, Lord God, always. Lord, let them flow upon the church of the firstborn, Lord, for you are the firstborn, Lord, among many brethren. Lord, I speak it right now in the name of Jesus that the hand of the Lord is upon this ministry. Hallelujah, that he would not let us turn into the right or to the left, but that we would go down the straight and narrow path. Hallelujah. as Revelation 3:10 says, that we would keep the word of his patience. He would keep us out of the hour of temptation that will come upon all the inhabitants of the earth. Hallelujah. He would deliver us with a mighty hand. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that your hand is upon this ministry. Hallelujah, Lord God. We come before you to serve you, Lord God. Hallelujah. For you're a holy God, a righteous God, a worthy God. Hallelujah. You're great and greatly to be praised. You are the Lord, ruler of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. All creation bow before you, Lord, and seek and save you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, that you would seek and save us, Lord. Oh, bless your mighty name, Lord God. Bless your holy name. You are righteous and worthy and holy. Holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. Hallelujah. The great I am. Hallelujah. You are an awesome God. You are the great I am. Yes, Lord. Age to age, still the same. Awesome God. You are the awesome God. Yes, Lord. You are the great I am. Yes, Lord. Age to age, still the same. Awesome God. Father, we praise you right now, Lord God. We lift your name on high. Yes, Lord, you are mighty. You are greatly to be praised. Hallelujah, Lord God. Father, to speak that blessing, Lord. I had to stop and worship the Lord. Brothers and sisters, you have to be led by the Spirit. Hallelujah. I had to speak his blessings upon you right now. Speak the blessings of the Lord upon everyone that's watching this right now. Of health, wealth, wisdom, peace, joy, and love. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. May the Lord rule and reign over you. Those who want to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Oh, it's acquired by faith. Ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and it'll be opened unto you. Jesus said. Jesus said in Luke chapter 11. Which son asked his father for bread, and he'd give him a stone? Or asked for a fish, and he'd give him a snake? How much you, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children? How much more your heavenly Father, who is perfect, love to give the Holy Spirit to those who ask? Luke chapter 11. Brothers and sisters, hallelujah. Receive, ask, and you shall receive. Physical healing, spiritual healing, mental healing. Receive it. Receive it in Jesus' name. Receive your healing in Jesus' name. Receive deliverance in Jesus' name. Receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. Receive your salvation in Jesus' name. Call upon his name. Repent of your sins. Hallelujah. Tell him. Tell him all that's in your heart. Hallelujah. For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks, Jesus said. Speak by faith out of your mouth. Hallelujah. Decree and declare. He is the Lord God Almighty, the ruler of your life. You're not your own, but you've been bought with a price. Tell him, tell him, tell him he owns you. Hallelujah. Here I am, Lord. Send me. Here am I, Lord. Use me. Hallelujah. As Isaiah said in Isaiah chapter 6, when the Lord asked him and said to the son in the temple, the year King Uzziah died, he said, who will go for us? Who will go for us? And Isaiah said, here am I. Send me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he even said, Lord, I'm a man of unclean lips. And the Lord sent an angel and took a coal of fire off the altar and touched his lips, symbolizing the fire of the Spirit, the cleansing. Hallelujah. The sanctification by the Spirit of God through the blood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The blood that was to come. If you read in Hebrews, you'll see that all the blood of bulls and goats that was used by Israel when Jesus died, his blood, that all that blood that was used was counted as the blood of Christ in Hebrews. God bless you all, brothers and sisters. I will end it here. Speak that may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he lift up his countenance upon you. May let it make his face to shine upon you and give you his peace. I speak it right now in the name of Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, the one and only begotten Son of the Most High God. Bless you, brothers and sisters, in Jesus' name.